Is there a downside to the microkernel-based approach? Well, there is. There is a potential for performance loss. Now, consider this monolithic structure. Let's say this application makes a call to the file system to open a file. The application slips through this red line into the hardware address space of the operating system, runs in privileged mode because the operating system may have to do certain things that are privileged, and therefore the hardware architecture of the CPU usually allows a privileged mode for execution of the operating system code. So now the app is now inside the operating system in a privileged mode with one instruction usually called a trap instruction. For example, a system call results in a trap into the operating system. And once inside the operating system, all the work that needs to be done in order to satisfy the file system call that the app made, for instance, contacting the storage manager, contacting the memory manager, and so on, all of that are available as components within this blob, which means that those components can be accessed at the speed of normal procedure call in order to handle the original request from this application. On the other hand, if you look at a microkernel-based structure, the application has to make an IPC call in order to contact the service, which is in this case a file system service, let's say, which means that the application has to go through the microkernel, making the IPC call, going up to the file system, and the file system does the work, makes another IPC call in order to deliver the results of that system service back up to the application. So the minimum traversal that you can see is going from the application to the microkernel to the file system, and back into the microkernel, and back up to the application. Potentially, there may be many more calls that may happen among servers that are sitting above the microkernel, because a file system may have to contact the storage manager, and the file system may have to contact the memory manager. All of those are server processes living above the microkernel, and all of them require IPC for talking to one another. So what that means is that with this structure, there is a potential that we may have to switch between the address spaces of the application and many services that are living on top of the microkernel. Whereas in the case of the monolithic structure that I showed you here, there is only two address space switches, one to go from the application into the operating system and the other to return back to the application. Whereas in a microkernel-based design, there could potentially be several address space switches depending on the number of servers that need to be contacted in order to satisfy one system call that may be emanating from the application.